Oh, sorry, I didn't see there. Welcome to Pillow Talk. My name's Anna, and today we're here to delve into the intriguing world of sleepovers. So, grab a hot chockey, get nice and snuggly, and join us on this wild ride. The first of our wonderful contestants is Charlie. He's known worldwide for his amazing sleepover planning. Let's hear from the man himself about his sleepover skills.
Hi, I'm Charlie Weber. Hi there, I'm Charlie Weber, and I live in sunny California. I've been planning sleepovers since the dawn of time, and my specialities are music, movies, and midnight snacks. I've won many awards for my impeccable sleepover skills, and I've had sleepovers with many celebrities, such as Harry Styles, Georgia Smith, and Zendaya. I'm going to win this competition, and I'm going to prove to the world that I can host the best sleepover.
Now, over to our other amazing contestant. She's known for her expertise in board games, video games, and party games. Let's hear it from Beth.
Hi, I'm Bethany Clapton, and I'm from Wales. No matter what, I'm the best sleepover planner ever. Other people ain't got shit on me. I run this game 24/7, and my sleepovers are known worldwide for being the most entertaining sleepovers ever. I have marvellous tastes in party games, board games, video games, to keep the masses entertained. I'm winning this game show for my family back at home, and to prove that I'm the best sleepover planner in the world. Watch out, Charlie. I'm coming for you, bruv.
Guys, welcome to Pillow Talk. How are we feeling?
Oh, I'm fantastic. Thank you very much
feeling
for having us, Anna.
Feeling sleepier?
I'm so tired.
You could say that.
How are you?
I'm okay. Thank you for asking, Beth. All right, guys, what would you like to do first? We could listen to music, we could make some food, or actually, do you know what? I have been really loving watching films lately. I don't know about you.
Same.
But, you know, at a sleepover, you do sometimes find yourself in the situation where you're just scrolling through Netflix, like, to no end, trying to find a decent film to watch. And you know Netflix, sometimes you get lost in all the films.
There's just so many films.
It's a bit overwhelming, isn't it? Mm. And, you know, before you know it, everyone has fallen asleep. So, one thing I'd love to know is, guys, since we're talking to the movie professional, Charlie, what are some of your kind of go-to movie choices for a good sleepover?
Well, thank you very much, Anna. It's a pleasure to be back. And as you said, with the problem is with nowadays is sometimes you just have too much choice. Mm. And I feel like obviously last year I won Netflix's big time scroller of the year.
Wow. And, you know what? I saw that, Charlie. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I thought that went to someone else.
No, it was me. I put the flick in Netflix and I'd be flicking through shows left, right and centre.
Is there a flick in Netflix?
There
I
is.
It's flicks.
I think it's flicks.
Well, I've been flicking all year, Anna, through those shows and series. For the best sleepover show or TV or film or it's a hard choice. You need something that's going to be a bit of powwow in the theatre.
Okay. But what's powwow, Charlie?
Oh, you know when you see it.
Okay,
Anna.
I'm sure I will then, Charlie.
Yeah.
But I feel like you need something that's going to keep people interested. You don't want people dozing off. You want people to stay awake. So I feel like for that in that case, I'm going to go for In the Night Garden.
Wow. In the Night Garden, is that a film, Charlie?
It's a series.
Okay. Well, I mean, we're looking for more kind of films. Beth, why don't you have a go? What's your like most nostalgic kind of film? What reminds you of your childhood?
Probably Shrek 2.
Oh, yeah.
You know the one where they're like in the kingdom?
Is that the one with all the dragon babies, the donkey babies? Is that 3?
I don't know. I think that's 3.
I can only really remember
number 2
one.
Is when you know the frog dies. You know the dad is a frog.
Oh, do you know what? I don't have a lot of memories of Shrek 2, but I do remember Shrek 1.
What?
Fiona dies.
No, her dad does.
Her dad's a frog?
Yeah, well, he got turned into a frog.
Oh, that's weird. Well, okay, guys, what are your favourite films? What are your go-tos?
I'll let Beth take the stage for this one.
Okay, mine's probably Shaun of the Dead.
Nice, yeah.
Panetta Trilogy.
Good choice, Beth. Although, so I don't know, I prefer Hot Fuzz, I think.
Really?
Yeah, although you know that scene with the spy, the church spire at the end.
Oh, that's not good, is it?
Or it makes me cringe, honestly. Same. But, you know, it's worth it, honestly.
I feel that's my second favourite, to be honest.
Do you know what? My friend actually saw Bill Nye in a cafe recently.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, just thought
Bill Nye, the science guy.
Crazy. I mean, he is in Hot Fuzz, that's why I'm saying it. But Charlie, what's your favourite film?
Crikey, Anna, what question?
I've got an even better one coming up, Charlie, so just you wait.
God, I wouldn't put it past you. God, I was going to have to say, for my favourite film ever, Sleepless in Seattle.
Nice, Charlie. Mm. What's it about?
It's about Seattle, Anna.
Okay. And sounds interesting, Charlie.
It's a true, exciting film that documents a love story in Seattle.
Well, I mean, they sound sleepless, Charlie, so it can only be exciting, can't it?
You'll all be right. Up all night, Anna.
Okay. Well, guys, if you could star in any film, what would it be and why? Give me a reason. Personally, I'd choose a Western. Mm. Give me Three Amigos, for sure. Mm. It's kind of a Western.
Oh, well, I've actually thought about this for many moons now, Anna.
Okay, hopefully it'll be short then, Charlie.
It will be. Okay. And it's going to be, if I could be in any film, I'd be Spider-Man. I feel like Tom Holland.
Good choice.
I reckon I'll give Tom Holland a run for his money.
Would you not rather be Miles Morales, though?
No.
Oh, okay.
Miles doesn't have MJ. And obviously, I feel like that's a key role to the
I mean, to be Spider-Man. Fair, Zendaya is your favourite actress of all time.
She is my favourite person of all time ever.
Person.
Actress.
Even more than your mum or something.
Yeah, my mum hasn't got an Oscar, Zendaya.
I hope she's not watching this.
Sorry, mum.
Beth, what's your answer?
You know what, probably High School Musical.
Oh, nice.
I feel like I can, you know.
But like, when you want to choose something that's like pretty crazy, like I want to be a cowboy, but I can't because I'm from Gloucestershire and I'm not a man, so, you know.
You don't have like a cowgirl.
Yeah, I guess, but like what's, you know, it's a bit weird like being in the like south of America, is that where they are? I don't know. Arizona or something with an English accent.
Probably. Yeah. We're all inclusive nowadays, Anna. You can be what you want.
I hope so. You know what? I'll go down then. I'll be a cowboy. Thank you, guys. I feel great.
You've
now.
Got this, man. I believe in you.
Well, Charlie, they really don't call you the professional for nothing. Well done. But, Beth, games are more your kind of thing, aren't they?
Yeah.
So, why don't you tell me about some movies that like keep people up and going, energised for the night?
Some movies?
Yeah.
Probably Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift is probably one of them.
Charlie, is that one of your favourites?
I'd say that it's one of my favourite films ever.
Oh, really? Well, guys, maybe we'll give that a watch. Seems like it's going to be a good sleepover so far. And we've only just begun, right? Well, you know, now I'm in the mood to watch a film. I don't know about you guys. So do you want to decide what to watch?
Of course.
Yeah? Yeah? Right, okay. I have a fun way of deciding this, guys. I think the best way to decide this is to play a game of literal movie titles.
How does that sound?
I don't know how else we'd do it.
Cool. Well, I will show you all a series of pictures that represent a movie title. For example, if I show a picture of a campsite and a rock, the answer would be Camp Rock. Let's work as a team, everyone, and try to figure it out together. Are you guys ready?
I'm born ready.
Okay, let's see if you guys can get the first one. Let's have a look.
Oh God! What is the second picture?
I don't know.
I mean, it's like a bed.
I'm still
like
stuck on the first picture.
Well, I mean, it could be chest or hair.
Chest.
Either one. Take your picking.
And
chest, man. Bed.
Well, that's an old bedroom. Do you know what's an old bedroom called?
Chamber.
A dresser. Okay.
And Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets.
Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. Are you sure, Beth? Is that your final answer?
I think so.
Okay.
I can't.
Don't know what you're getting Harry for.
Well, do you know what, Beth?
Harry.
Charlie hasn't got it, so let's go with Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets.
Yep.
Let's see. Nice, Beth. Do you know what? That one was actually pretty complicated. I'm quite impressed.
Yeah. Mm.
Well done, Beth.
Thank you.
Okay, Charlie, do you want to try and win the next one?
I mean, I'm going to.
Okay, well, let's see, course, Charlie. Yeah. Let's see if you're right.
Jeffrey Dahmer of the Dusty Moon.
Jeffrey Dahmer of the Dusty Moon. What a great film, Charlie.
I don't feel like that's a film.
Well, like, could it be like Criminal or something?
Well, crikey.
Criminal of the Flowery Night. I don't know.
Oh, wow.
That was very difficult.
Serial killer of the... Oh, wow.
Flowery Moon.
Flowery Moon, yeah. I think you're right there, Beth. I'm going to stick with you on that one.
Wait, what's your answer, Beth?
Serial killer of the Flowery Moon.
Serial killer of the Flowery Moon. Let's see if you're correct.
Dahmer for the night.
Oh.
Killers of the Flower Moon.
Oh well.
I feel like we were pretty close.
At least you failed as bad as each other.
Have you seen that movie?
I haven't. Have you?
I thought you were like a movie expert.
Well, obviously it's got Leonardo in it, so I'll give it a watch.
Okay. Fair enough. Charlie, Beth is still a point ahead of you. Do you want to see if you can get the next one?
I'll be closing that gap. Don't you worry, Anna.
Okay. Let's see, Charlie. Mm-hmm.
Oh. Oh, okay. Paragraph.
I'm a bit stuck on this one too, I can't lie.
I'm confused.
Okay, paragraph, well, what's the second one? That's pretty easy.
Construction.
I'm just as confused as you now because I thought it'd be crane.
Paragraph crane.
Paragraph crane.
Writing crane.
Writing crane.
Writing.
Guys, we're running out of time here.
I don't know.
We're going to have to come up with a final
answer. I'm
going to
go for word construction.
Okay, Charlie's going in for it with word construction. Let's see if Charlie really has closed that gap.
Come on.
Parasite.
Oh. That one's a bit of like wordplay, isn't it?
That is wordplay, yeah.
I mean, maybe it's a bit too complicated for your brains.
Small, yeah.
Well, you know what? Maybe we just need to watch an energising film. Maybe we need to watch Tokyo Drift.
I think we do. We need to get some powwow into us.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Definitely some powwow needed. Yeah. Okay, let's see if we can get the next one, guys. Come on.
I've got a good feeling about this one.
Go on then, Charlie.
Why are these so difficult?
Rock the Aussies and... Dude Perfect, kissing James Corden.
Is that Dude Perfect?
I don't want to repeat myself.
Wait.
I swear that's Dude Perfect. That is Dude Perfect.
Yeah.
And that's James Corden. No.
James Corden. why is he kissing him?
I don't know. Why is Dude Perfect there?
Well, you've got to think, is it James Corden or is it... Kiss.
Smithy. It could be Smithy.
Is it something to do with kissing or does something to do with James Corden? That's got to be specific.
Well, it's definitely James Corden.
Oh, this is really hard.
God, this is a nail biter.
The James Corden kiss is like, put me off a bit.
We are running out of time here. Come on, I need a final answer ASAP.
The Aussie / New Zealand flip-flops are real.
Angus thongs and perfect snogging.
Angus thongs and perfect snogging. Let's see if Beth got it.
Oh.
That is insane, Beth.
I'm a genius.
I mean...
I'm actually a genius. Okay.
But don't Americans call them thongs?
No, because
that's the
Australian.
Aussies.
Like flip-flops.
Oh, that was clever.
That, you know what, Beth?
That's too advanced for me.
I wouldn't have got that if it was Blue Moon Tuesday. And
I'll just let you sit with that. Okay, that's let's see really if you guys funny. Can get the next one.
Oh, I'd have to do that.
Mini... Minions.
Oh yeah. Do you want to go for that, Beth?
Yeah.
Okay, let's just do that.
Oh my god, I'm not having a good day.
Oh, come on.
I mean, when have you ever, Charlie? Do you know what I mean?
I'm
but Beth
so
did get it right. Well done, Beth.
I don't know what you mean, Anna.
Do you know what? I actually really enjoyed the Minions movie, but it got really bad rep, yeah. I liked the bit when they were in the cave, the ice cave.
It didn't really stand out to me. I didn't
well,
watch it.
Well, I think it's more for... the intellectual kind of audience.
Exactly. See, Anna, I thought from a cinematography
standpoint. How many points have you got?
Oh, yeah.
How many points have you got? How many points?
Shut up.
Maybe they're all, you know, not advanced enough for Charlie. I mean, you know how Charlie's brain power is.
Exactly. Now and again, even the smartest minds are disarrayed by the silliest of puzzles.
Exactly, Charlie. Well, do you know what? Let's see if the next one's advanced enough for you, Charlie.
I think Shakespeare did say that. And Morgan Freeman.
Love the IT crowd.
Wreck-It Ralph?
Oh my god, man, why are you so quick?
Okay, Ben, let's see if you got it right.
It's Fast and Furious, it's just like...
Wow. Charlie, come on, you've got to get the next one.
I don't know what's going on.
You've got to get at least one.
I don't know what's going on.
Okay, come on, Beth, be a bit kinder to me. Okay, you're going to win, so come on, Charlie.
We don't know that yet. The game's not over till it's over.
Yeah, but it has like 2 months left, Charlie. So.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Happy, angry Mr. Beth.
Oh, come on, guys. We're talking about Westerns earlier.
I don't really watch Westerns.
But this is famous.
Right, I don't know.
Just, oh,
God. God, wow, this
you
is...
You should get this.
Now, this is a real, real twister.
Charlie, think literally now. Come on, we're running out of time.
Happy,
the pressure's
happy,
on.
Angry.
Angry.
What? I'm sorry, but what
happy
is
angry
she?
Troll.
No, come
happy
on.
Angry
what, how does
princess.
She look? She doesn't
happy
look good, does
angry
she?
Happy, angry, ugly.
Happy, angry, ugly. Is that your final answer? Are you serious? Okay, just show it. Come on now.
I reckon that should be a point for me there.
Okay, I do feel
ugly.
A bit sorry for you, Charlie. You
give
can get that.
0.2.
I mean, he's not going to win anyway, so I'll give that to you.
The good, the bad, and the ugly.
All right, guys, can we have a look at the next one? Ooh. Oh, come on.
Oldies, the Goldies, wait.
I have no idea.
The odd movie.
What are they doing?
They're filming something.
Oh, no, food. I get it.
The move. The mood.
The good. Is that your final answer, Charlie?
The good,
the bad, and the ugly.
The good.
Charlie, we're running out of time. Do you just want to go with the good?
The good. I feel like you should go with the good.
That's
right, let's see if it's the good.
The good. Oh, it's not going to be the good, is it?
No. Oh,
the crude? Oh, yeah, that's a point.
I'll give you a quarter.
No.
Give us a half.
Beth, you're still going to win. You're like 4 points ahead.
This is the good.
The crude.
Yeah.
The crude, the good.
Okay, fine.
The crude,
I won't
the
give
good,
you a
the
point
ugly.
For that. Okay.
Ooh. Orange Fiction.
Pulp Fiction.
Jesus Christ, Charlie. What is going on today?
Are you okay?
Okay, let's see if it's Pulp Fiction.
How's that pulp? It's an orange.
Orange.
Oh,
pulp.
And we've even got our Pulp Fiction vinyl in today.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You know what? I thought I'd, you know, set the mood a bit today. I don't know if our viewers can see.
Cracking film, one of my personal favourites.
Really?
Really, Charlie? What's your favourite part?
The bit when they're in the restaurant and they're sat down and she's like, I'm going to go powder my nose.
Oh, you have actually watched this?
I have actually watched it.
Well, now I'm in the mood to watch some film. I don't know about
Same.
You guys.
So, yeah. I mean, I feel a bit frustrated after that excruciating
that
loss.
That wasn't your best work, I don't think.
No,
you could say that, Beth.
I don't think it was. But well done, everyone.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Beth. And which one of those films would you like to watch? Out of all
Pulp
of them.
Pulp Fiction, maybe.
Pulp Fiction. What about The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly?
I feel like that was a personal favourite
yeah.
from mine.
Okay, because I haven't seen it before. Maybe we should.
And we've got to
it.
Get in that cowboy kind of mood.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, while we watched The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, Beth and Charlie played an epic game of non-alcoholic beer pong earlier. Let's hand over to my friend, the beer pong master.
Let the game begin. Thanks, Anna. And now over to the non-alcoholic beer pong championships. With, of course, your master, Harry Jones. Today we've got an exciting game with two close friends of mine, Charlie and Beth.
Hello.
Who I hope have been practicing for today, because it's going to be fierce competition. We all know the rules, but just to recap for the audiences at home, it's as simple as a regular game of beer pong. You throw it, you bounce it, it's got to go into a cup. However, as always, there's a twist. They must read the question that is underneath the cup. It is a truth question, and I expect you both, as always, to answer with 100% truth. I don't want any lies, don't want any fibs. I want it straight from the heart, as always. So, without further ado, you're both ready?
Yep.
Born ready.
Born ready.
Fantastic. Let the game begin. Okay, that was a rough first throw, but that's all right.
It's just all in the warm-up.
Over to yourself now.
Oh, no.
See, we're struggling a little bit. First one. Well done, Charlie. The
no.
first point.
Okay.
Now, what is that question?
Mm-hmm. What's the strangest place you've ever fallen asleep in?
Well, where has it been? What was the circumstances?
At a festival, in a crowd, fell asleep.
What were you falling asleep to? Clearly, wasn't a very good artist.
I mean, I was really tired. I'm not going to lie. No sleep for the last week.
Always modern music, not keeping even the youth of today, it's not keeping them awake. Still your turn though,
right.
So it's getting tense. Oh, that's a point. Well done, Beth. Neck and neck now. Charlie, you know the rules. Read that question.
What's the most unexpected or strange thing you've ever found in your bed?
What is the most unexpected or strange thing you found in your bed? Remember, this is a family show.
I was in Spain.
Oh.
Yeah, we were in this lovely hotel down in Barcelona, I think.
Okay.
And there was just like a weird little lizard thing.
Oh, my.
I didn't notice it at first, but when I was like lying down, I just felt something on my legs. and it was just like this lizard.
And that was quite a shock to the system.
Oh, I mean, I couldn't say I was expecting it, Harry, no.
Well, fair enough, you seem to have handled it like a champ, much like you are today. So, if you want to throw that ball. Oh, that was quite a shocking display, I'm afraid.
Can I have a rethrow?
No.
Absolutely not, no. Beth. I'm going to pass over. You've got your ball already, see? That's brilliant showmanship. That's another point to Beth, who's currently taken the lead. So, get that cup out of the way and read that question for us.
If you could have a mythical creature as a bedtime pet, which one would you choose and why? Well, I've actually thought about this many, many times.
Well, of course. Same.
And I'd have a unicorn because I'd have his horn to hang my cardigan up on.
So you're going to be using a unicorn as just like a piece of furniture, really?
I'd say more like a clothing peg. But do you know what I mean? How many people have got a unicorn to put their cardi on?
How many people have a unicorn?
Exactly. That's why I want one.
I think you might need to broaden your horizon with the unicorn, but each to their own. Go on then, Beth.
Right.
That's another point to Beth, who's currently on a two
streak. The cross
keys
haven't been doing you good, have they?
I don't think they have. You're going to have words with your trainer. Currently, Beth's been only away for a year and she's kicking butt.
Have you ever had a supernatural or paranormal experience?
Ooh, bit spooky, ladies and gentlemen. Well, Halloween has just been, of course.
Yeah, well, I mean, I can't really say that for too sure. Once I was sleeping around a good friend of mine, and just in the middle of the night, just felt something on my back. Do you know what I mean?
Wasn't the lizard again?
Oh, but bloody hope not. I couldn't tell you what it was for sure. But I mean, I think it's one of those things you just don't want to find out, really.
One of those sort of supernatural elements that you just don't really want to engage with.
It was either Kai or a ghost, and I'm not here to find out about it.
Well, that's understandable. We'll move on. I'm going to say, because Beth's kind of kicking butt right now, you've got some catching up to do.
I do.
I'm going to say, if you get another point, I think we're going to call it there. So you've got really some ground to make up.
I do. It's fine.
It's your shot. Oh! And he's already making bets on his word. Well done, Charlie.
Okay.
Beth, read the question.
What's the worst thing you've done on a dare?
Is the worst thing you've done on a dare? Remember,
probably
families.
A really dodgy prank call or something.
Ooh.
I can't really
Who
recall.
Who to? Hopefully not anyone important
probably like
myself.
Probably like Mackie's or something.
To Mackie?
Yeah.
Why, what are you prank calling
got
Mackie's
them on speed
for?
Dial.
You've got... What are you doing with Mackie's on speed dial? Get some health in your diet. Go to...
They sell salads.
I wouldn't be too keen on the McDonald's salad.
Nah, they're not great.
I'd say take your next shot.
Oh my God.
As the game's really carrying close. On, I'm sure people at home are clenching on their butt seats.
Oh my God.
And Charlie's leveling the game here.
That's not fair, that's not fair.
And that's the front one gone. That's quite a risky one to take. That's what I like to save. What's the question?
If you instantly learn a skill from one of your dreams, what would it be? Probably like teleporting. I teleport a lot in my dreams, and I think maybe that's what
I
should do.
We all teleport a lot, isn't it? It's very odd. You've yet to figure out why. Maybe I'll talk to some of my dream friends back at the studio. Guys, it's been going on for a while. I think it's going to be winner takes all now. Next one in to win it. You guys ready? Charlie, your throw. Oof. Now, before Beth reads, you get a chance to throw in his cup.
I can't believe this. I'm in shock.
If you get it in, you could still win. You have one.
I need to focus now.
Here you go.
Right.
And we have a winner. Well done, Beth.
Thank
but before
you. Thank
we get to celebrations, Charlie, you know the rules.
I do. Question is, if you could have any fictional character to tuck you in at night, who would it be?
Oh, what a brilliant question.
What a lovely one to finish on. Oh, well, I'd say it'd be a leprechaun.
Just a
nice little happy Irish fellow to tuck me in at night. Just a cute little ginger boy.
That's cute. Yeah.
Pot of gold beside my bed, nice little rainbow over my sheets and ass. Lovely. What more could you want, Harry?
What a lovely image Charlie's painted there for all of us.
That's lovely.
Well, Charlie, you played a good game, but unfortunately, today just wasn't your day. Beth, congratulations.
Thank you.
Another victory in the pocket for another beer pong championship.
In the last year.
50th victory.
I know.
You've been going up and down the country getting your victories, and here you are, back where it all started, to claim that title once again. Well, that's all we've got time for on the beer pong. Anna, I'm handing it back over to you in the sleepover studio.
Thanks, Harry. Wow.
What a game that really was.
Absolutely, Charlie. I mean, Beth, congratulations. How do you feel that game was?
I just feel so amazing after that.
Honestly, like, I was
especially
beating
him
the whole time. Yeah.
I mean,
it's not the hardest thing in the world.
It's not, but like when you shut him up, it's good. Like,
I mean, I did expect him to be quite good at beer pong. You know, as the beer drinker he is. Yeah. I know how Charlie loves to neck a Stella.
You know, but the Cross Keys hasn't done him any good, really.
Oh, no. He hasn't been going to the Cross Keys anymore ever since Corinne stopped working.
His
heart was broken.
It's safe to say, when Corinne was there, I was getting a bit distracted now and again. And when Corinne
dark
left,
game
it
wasn't
the same. It was.
Everyone's got a bit of Corinne in their heart.
Everyone should have a bit of Corinne.
Everyone's got a bit of
lives.
A Corinne shaped hole in their heart now.
We all do. Well,
I'm just
it's fine, because I'll be Corinne-ing on and I'll be going into the next round with hopeful hearts, and I'll be ready to beat Beth.
That's good, Charlie.
I doubt it.
Well, whilst you at home watch that epic game of beer pong here in the sleepover studio, we, of course, watch the film we picked in our previous game. One thing I love about Good, Bad, the Ugly is the soundtrack.
I know.
Don't you think?
It's so good.
It's just so ripe.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that's one way of putting it. It's very fitting. It makes me feel like I'm standing on the edge of a cliff, and like, I have my thumbs and my belt loops.
Like ready to rip
and
out.
And I'm looking like that. And I'm looking like,
makes me think of my old pal, John Wayne.
Nice, Charlie. R.I.P.
Rest in peace, John.
Well, speaking of music, what are your guys' favourite music? What's your favourite band, song, type of music?
Well, I feel like that's a very heavy loaded question there, Anna.
Pick one, Charlie.
Badder Dan.
Oh, I don't know what that is.
Is that a song?
Never listened to Badder Dan.
I know Bangarang.
Oh, no, not Bangarang. Badder Dan.
Okay, you know what? We'll leave that as a mystery. Seems like you're quite a mysterious fella. What about you, Beth?
I like a bit of, like, heavy metal.
Oh, yeah. I know you love your Limp Bizkit, Beth.
Oh, Limp Bizkit.
Absolutely.
It's just one of those days.
You don't want to make up.
Everything sucks.
PG, let's keep it PG, guys.
Well,
I don't know about you guys, but I could sit and chat about music with you guys all day. But we do have a show to be getting back to, I'm afraid. So instead of talking about music, we could sing some songs. How does that sound?
It sounds good.
I've been told by Mariah Carey herself that I've got a voice of an angel.
When did you meet Mariah?
Literally last Christmas. Ripe.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
That's quite fitting, isn't it?
Yeah, very next day she gave it away. I don't
know. This year, gonna.
Well, I'm going to give it to someone special.
Guys, are you up for some singing?
I am, yes.
Yep. Okay, the game is very simple. I will show my friends lyrics to a popular song, and the first person to answer correctly wins a point. However, if you do not guess correctly within 5 seconds, the question will be handed over to the other person. You ready?
I was born ready, Anna.
Okay, let's play.
You said it was true love, but wouldn't that be hard? So unfair. I don't know.
No.
Go on, Beth, you had it.
This is Beth's.
You could love anyone, but that means you have a heart or something like that.
You could love anyone, but that means you would have a heart. Let's see if you got that right, Beth.
I don't know if that's right. Mm.
Not the biggest thing. You can't love anyone, because that could mean
you had a heart. Oh. I'll give that one to you, Beth. It's close enough.
That's really generous, thank you.
I am feeling in a
generous
mood.
I don't really listen to her.
Neither do I.
I'm not a fan.
She's all right, to be honest.
I mean, she's done nothing wrong, but like, I just don't like her music. Okay, do you know what I mean?
Let's see if you get the next one. Charlie, try and win this one. Come on, mate.
No, now. Can you love me again?
Oh, no.
I need to know now. Can you love me again?
What are you doing with your hands?
I'm hitting them bloody drums, do you know what I mean?
Okay.
Absolute tune, that takes me back to FIFA 16, back
Charlie,
in the day.
I'm just gonna see if you got that, okay? Memory's all well and good, but let's see.
You weren't there, you gotta be there.
I was there in 2016.
Maxing out my mum's card and FIFA points.
Well, you did get it, Charlie, and I think that's like your first actual win of the day.
Yeah.
Well done, or of the night, I should say. Well done, Charlie. All right, let's see if you guys can get the next one. And Mariah was right, can I just say?
Voice of an angel.
God, literally. You guys, you're making me blush.
Okay, let's see the next one. Tell me if I could
send my heart to you. So when I die, which I must do, will it shine down here for you? I can keep going.
What, that vibrato was something else, Charlie.
Vibrate.
Oh, man, that's a good song.
Okay,
what I mean.
Let's see if you got it right, Charlie. I can't even remember. So when
I got it right. Does it shine down here for you?
With you.
Change of key there, Charlie.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Change it up. A cappella real quick.
A cappella.
Yeah.
All right, Charlie's ahead of this round. Let's see. Beth, can you steal the next one?
Well, that means two
Probably
points.
Not. Shut up.
Top dog.
Oh, no. I don't know, because I don't listen to
I hate Taylor Swift.
I don't know.
Nobody asked.
I actually don't know.
I don't know.
Okay, neither do I, actually. So let's just see, because I don't think any of us could have gone.
I actually don't know.
Yeah, man. If it was Kanye, I'd...
No. Okay, right. Can you guys get the next one? Let's see if you know this one. Anyway.
I'm ready.
Don't lose faith, Beth. Okay, let's
Second
see.
Second best, Beth.
God, shut up. Hey, she goes, either a little too high or a little too low.
No self-esteem, that birdie girl, because she thinks she's made of candy.
Please, I'm going to
go to Beth here, Charlie. I'm sorry.
What? Not even.
But you are ahead here. I want to give her a chance.
I used to be obsessed with Robbie Williams when I was little. You know, I named every single puffin after him.
You know the Effie Stoneham's England? In the music video.
Yeah, I know.
Let's see if Beth got that one, guys. Sorry to cut you off there. Good job. Neck and neck, guys. Can you get the final
the
one?
The grand finale.
Yeah, let's see.
Let's see.
Your skin. Oh yeah, your skin and bones turn into something beautiful.
Do you know what? Charlie's range there.
Oh yeah, exactly, my god.
Exactly. Soprano to whatever it's called down there.
This is not fair.
I've got to give Charlie that one. Let's see if he got it right. Charlie did win that round, I'm afraid. But it's okay, Beth, because you won anyway. So I'm
in.
No, in general,
the first thing in his life.
She won
Congrats.
Two of the rounds. But I'm giving this one to you, Charlie, so be grateful. There we go. Okay, well, that concludes our final game. Now, that last game has left me feeling a bit peckish, you guys, and
same.
I could definitely go for a big midnight
my tummy's
snack.
Rumbling.
And you know how I love my midnight snacks, how I love to talk about them. Mm. So, one question before we go to sleep. If you could eat one meal for the rest of your life, what would it be and why? Beth, what would you eat?
I'm going to pass it on to Charlie first, I reckon.
I was really hoping that you'd take the cake there, Beth. Well, speaking of cake, tonight this week's spectacular scrumptious meal of choice is actually going to be a... Oh, it's like this weird kind of like blackcurrant disc.
What?
So like, I think it's
like... No. Let me cook. So like, imagine like a meringue, like the texture. But it's like in a little disc, and you bite into it, and it was like this gooey, meringue kind of like black currency.
Do you mean like eaten mess?
No, I would have said eaten mess. I mean like a meringue kind of black currency.
Right. I'm not going to take that attitude there, Charlie.
No, not like an eaten mess. It was like, what's it called? The little French things, the little biscuits.
Macarons. Macarons.
Yes. It was like a macaron.
What do you call them?
A macaron.
A macaron.
But it was like a black currency macaron. You know what? I'm not a big fan of French food, but I thought that was pretty good.
I mean, that's pretty normal, Charlie. I'm quite surprised, that is very normal. Actually. Yeah.
I mean, I was going to say my chocolate-covered pineapple, but I thought that'd be a bit too extravaganza
Why didn't we just come back to that chocolate-covered pineapple?
Yeah.
When?
So you get like bits of like chunks of pineapple, and like you've been to a chocolate fountain before, haven't you now?
Like, one accessible to the public?
Like one that's a fountain that spits out chocolate.
Yeah.
You go up to one of them with a bit of pineapple and you like dip it in
And it's like, you know how sometimes pineapple leaves that little tangy little bunch of punches and jabs onto the back of your throat that like hurts a bit, yeah. like tickles?
The tickles? I don't know what kind of pineapple you're eating, Charlie.
The right ones.
Okay.
And instead of kind of having that little tingly, little sparkly, punchy sensation, it's smooth, you know what I mean?
Okay. It's Can't nice. Get on the thinking ship with that one, Charlie. Well, Can't get on board there.
Hop aboard, Anna, because we've got dark chocolate, white chocolate, and milk chocolate.
I'll happily Spoiled pass, Charlie.
Exactly, you
I
know
mean,
me.
Pineapple and chocolate, yeesh.
Sorry. Don't knock it before you try it.
I'm going to pass on that one, Charlie.
Are you going to walk the plank on this one, Anna?
I'm not even going to get on the ship in the first place, Charlie.
Oh. Well, you're missing out, because...
No, you keep it. You keep it, Charlie. It's all yours.
All right, but don't come crying to me.
I'm not going to be come crying to you. How many times do I have to tell you I don't want it?
If you want, you're going to tell yourself that to make you feel better.
Okay,
all right.
Charlie, you have the last word there, Charlie. Beth, what about you? Oh, you're pensive in thought there, Beth.
I'm thinking like a classic toad in the hole.
Oh
but
my
instead
God,
of
yeah.
sausage, it's like black pudding.
You're weird, man.
And instead of gravy, it's milk.
Are you trying to make me angry? I mean, I wanted
no,
weird.
No, actually, my real
I
answer.
I wanted crazy.
My real answer.
No.
It's monkey stew. Yeah, I know. Don't look at me like that.
Do you know what?
You're a freak.
Pineapple and chocolate
sorry.
Sounds
sorry.
Appealing to me now.
I'm so,
I can't.
Don't leave
don't
brother hanging.
Dap him up.
I can't. Sorry, monkey stew.
No, I was joking.
That's okay. What's your real answer then? Oh my gosh.
Apple pie.
Apple pie. Is that your actual
pie.
Answer?
All of that for apple pie. That's like the most basic answer ever.
He didn't go with toad in the hole.
What do you want for dinner, Beth? Chips.
Guys.
I mean, macarons, they are. Macarons.
I've never had
a
macaron.
It's not like a macaron, it's like a meringue.
That's a macaron.
Never had
okay,
that.
Whatever.
You weren't there for Anna.
Well, guys, not gonna lie, this conversation has left me tired.
I'm exhausted.
And disgraced.
And confused.
Okay.
And
you and me both here, Charlie. I don't know what Beth's been up to.
Oh, she's been chatting. It's all that drink. I reckon she's been on the too much beer pong, Anna.
It's
making her go loopy.
Well, I think it's time to wrap up our sleepover, guys. Sorry, but I made all of our beds up nice and cosy for us. Charlie, sorry, you're sleeping on the floor again.
Sorry.
But let's head to bed, guys. Have you had fun on our sleepover?
I've loved it. Thank you very much, Anna.
Loved every
had
second.
Had so much fun, yeah.
Well, join us next weekend in the sleepover studio for another cosy episode of Pillow Talk. Good night and sleep tight.